Music Access. Hello, Music Access listeners. I'm James from the Royal Pirates, and I've been hosting Music Access in Aaron's place since last Tuesday. So it's been less than a week since I've been here, but I'm already seeing some familiar names on the message board and remembering each other's names and calling in naturally and listening to what we have to say to each other. Don't you think this means that we're already friends? I think so. And although it's only been a week since I started hosting Music Access, I'm still gonna call you guys my MA friends. We're good friends that remember each other's names and listen to each other, right? So, hello my MA friends. What do you think? How does that sound? Our very first song on Monday, December 1st, was Problem by Ariana Grande featuring Iggy Azalea. Hello, MA friends, amigos, compadres. I am James of the Royal Pirates, and it's the first day of December and the first day of this week. And it's the seventh day that I'm filling in for Aaron here on Music Access, and I'm only going to be here until tomorrow. So, in order to make every moment count, every single moment is going to count with me here, all right? I'm going to make sure that it's more fun and filled and exciting for you guys today. So if there's anything that you guys want to say to me or share with me right now, please post up your messages on our message board. I'll be waiting. And come to think of it, there's only 1 month left this year, and we have something coming up that's really, really important to us, my band, Royal Pirates. We've got a show coming up on Tuesday, December 16th at 8 p.m. It's called the TY Party. For more details, check that out elsewhere online. Okay, so before we get started, here's a look at what we'll be doing today. In the first hour, we'll have our Music Access family introducing themselves with Who Am I Part 2 and AA Music Quiz. Meanwhile, for the second hour, we have a Monday corner called My Treasure Box with the lovely Tasha. So this corner is all about the special things that make us think back on the precious moments in our lives. For example, a blanket that I had since I was born, an article of clothing that I no longer fit into, but it brings back fond memories, or a lucky charm that I use when I'm especially nervous. So we're going to talk about all of your special treasures. Just remember to write My Treasure Box on your title and share with us what kind of special, memorable items you have. So we'll introduce those messages in just a bit with our visual queen, Tasha, who will join us in the studio. But here's how you can listen to Music Access with James of Royal Pirates and how you can participate. You can download the Arirang Radio or TuneIn Radio app on your smartphones, and you can also send us a message through the app using the comment function. You can also listen to us by visiting our website, www.arirangradio.com/musicaccess, and leave your messages there on our message board. You can also see our broadcast in real time. Another way you can tune in is through terrestrial DMB, but this is only available for our listeners living on Jeju Island. The frequencies are 88.7 for Jeju City, 88.1 for Seogwipo, and 101.9 for Daejeon. So, we talked about a lot of different ways you can tune into us, and if there's a song that you would like to hear during the program, you can send in your song request as well. Just remember to write request on your title and tell us a little bit about why you want to hear this song, okay? And I'll try hard to introduce as many of these messages from you guys as I can during the show. All right, well, we'll come back right after the song for message time. Up next, we've got Robin Thicke with Living in New York City.
I'm moving to New York.
The song you just heard was Robin Thicke's Living in New York City. And now it's already time to listen to your stories with message time. Alrighty. The first one is from Kaylee from France. She says, Bonjour, James. I hope that accent was okay. Goodbye, November, and welcome, December. How was your weekend? Did you rest a lot? Missed you so much, handsome guy. Well, thank you for calling me that. Appreciate it. But this weekend, I ate so much, and I feel bloated. But I feel, like, bloated in a good way. Like, I like how I'm feeling. I feel heavy, and it feels good to me. All right. Well, thank you. Thank you for the love. Moving on. Mara from the USA says, hey, James, I'm working out and your show is about to start. I ate way too much. Those Christmas cookies are my downfall. I'm not naturally skinny, so I gotta work my butt off to stay in shape. Plus, I want to live a nice, long, and healthy life. Sorry if I sound like a health nut. Anyway, good luck with the show today. Love from Seattle. Well, hello from Korea. I'm also a health nut, kind of, but I'm a little bit more spontaneous about when I choose to be, which means I'm rarely conscious about my health. But it's good to hear that one of us is, but thank you for the message, Mara. Herlin Chua from Malaysia says, disappeared for 3 days, and finally, I'm back. Yes, my internet connection is back. Finally, I can tune into Music Access today. Hello, James and MA friends. How was your weekend? I spent my weekend with my besties. We went for high tea and nonstop chatting. It's so fun. I wish I can go high tea with you. And of course, Royal Pirates and MA family too. Haha. It would be very interesting. I'm not sure what high tea is, but sounds... You spelled tea as in the drink. And I'm kind of thirsty, so I guess that's kind of cool. But all right. Well, sounds fun. Thank you, Herlinchua. That's a familiar name. Appreciate the love. And Satu from Finland says, hi, James. How are you? I haven't introduced myself. I'm Satu, a 17-year-old girl from Finland. Wow, hello. Thank you for hosting Music Access when our Aroni, or Aroni, is away. I actually went to Nui's Finland concert and met Aaron, and he recognized me as a listener of MA, and it was the happiest day of my life. Well, let's be friends, James. You sound like a really fun guy. Hugs and kisses. Satu, thank you. And I'm glad that you actually got to meet Aaron. It's kind of difficult to meet these, especially Aaron. He's a K-pop star, so it's kind of difficult to actually meet these people one-on-one, but I'm glad that you're able to do that, and I hope that one day we can play in Finland and we can meet you too. Well, thank you so much, Satu. Well, thanks so much to everyone for sending in your messages to Message Time, and let's listen to a song before we come back with Who Am I Part 2. All right, so next up, we've got Marie Digby's Your Love. I want to know you, and it's strange. We might be meeting for the first time, but I don't know how much I want to know. There's only one reason: your family. So let everyone who is curious know more about you. Introducing our Music Access family members. Who am I? I feel like there's nothing I can do 'cause of you. So I'm sure a lot of our MA family members will be really happy to hear this corner has made a comeback. Who Am I Part 2? So it's a corner to find out more about our Music Access family members, and of course, it'll help me find out more about you guys. So that's why we've brought back this corner. All you need to do is send me messages telling me about yourselves. Your name, your age, what you do, your nickname, your family relations, everything. What you like, what you hate, what you're into these days, etc. And you can talk to me about you, just like you're talking to your friend. Don't forget to write Who Am I on the title when you send your messages to our message board. And if you want to send me your messages for Who Am I Part 2, all you need to do is write Who Am I on your title and send it to me on our message board at www.arirangradio.com/musicaccess or through your smartphone application. Alrighty, let's listen to our first Who Am I Part 2. This is from Natharin from Malaysia. Hello, James. I am Natharin from Malaysia. I'm a 23-year-old university student studying pharmacy course. Sorry about that. I am a big fan of Royal Pirates and can sing along to every song of RP. No lies, gotta show you when RP comes to Malaysia. And seriously, I don't have a bias in RP, cause I see you three as a whole band that comes out with great music. Personally, I am playing piano and the drums. I am so interested in playing drums these days. But people around me tend to show me these unbelievable expressions when I tell them I'm a girl drummer. So, what do you think about being a girl drummer? And requests, she has a very special request. Can you say something to cheer for me since I will be having a final exam soon? First of all, thank you, Natharin, for sending in your message and telling us that you know every single song of Royal Pirates. When we go to Malaysia, I'm going to be staring at you only for about 5 minutes, a total of 5 minutes, because I'm going to be looking per song. But you better know each song. Anyway, but girl drummers. Okay, so growing up, one of my favorite bands was this small trio called The Studio Fix, and they were just an indie band, but all three of them were girls. And just to let you know, the most attractive, and when I say attractive, I mean charming, very charismatic member was the drummer, the girl drummer. So as long as you can do it with groove and with passion and, you know, just know what you're doing confidently, then I don't see any reason why that there's any reason to be afraid. Well, keep working hard and do your best on your drums and your final exam. Good luck. Thank you so much for sending this message, and I hope you keep listening to Music Access and send us lots more. Well, we're going to listen to another song before we come back with our second Who Am I message. Up next, it's one of my very favorite songs from the mega-talented band, the 1975 with Settle Down, requested by Amy of the UK. The song you just heard was Settle Down by the 1975. And it's time for our MA family to express everything about themselves with Who Am I Part 2. And we have messages coming on our message board right now, so let's listen to a couple more. Catherine from Canada says, "Hi James, my name is Catherine. I'm 20 years old and currently studying in the arts. I've been accepted at university in Asian studies as I love Asia since my birth. I think this is the best decision of my life. I have a big family, one big sister, one younger sister, and a young, very tall brother. My parents are divorced since 3 years. I live well with that, even if sometimes it's more difficult than I let people know. I'm the kind of person who's always smiling and taking care of the ones I love. I hate asking for help and prefer being independent. Sometimes it takes me in some problems. My nickname is Panda. The reason it's a secret." What? I want to know. Well, anyway, I like playing music, listening to it too. I like drawing too. And a lot of friends said I'm good, so I guess I am. Music is for me like air. I can't live without it. It helps me pass through the hard times. And now your song, Betting Everything, helps me let out all my stress with the end of the semester. Royal Pirates music is really enjoyable and makes me happier when life is sad. I hear you singing and your voice is wonderful. Hope you'll come to Canada, Quebec. A lot of my friends love you. Keep going, James. Know that you'll heal some hearts every day. I love you." Oh, this means a lot to me. I'm touched. Catherine, congratulations on being accepted in your university. I read that you said you hate asking for help. And I hope that you can overcome that, because we can't always do things alone. But it's good to see that you already have some sense of independence, Panda. And also, I guess I want to say, everyone always goes through a certain level of depression. It's relatively normal. But for me, music was the cure as well. Whether it was writing it, playing it like really loud and screaming along with it, or just going to shows and concerts, buying my favorite band's t-shirt, music was always the cure for me, and I'm glad that you have a similar outlet. But no buts. I just thank you for writing in. All right, thanks, Catherine. I'm happy that you introduced yourself to us, and I hope you keep listening and sending more messages to us. For all of you who had your messages read during Who Am I, if I see your names come up on the message board, I'll try to remember to give you a shout out. And if you want to send me your messages for Who Am I Part 2, all you need to do is write Who Am I on your title and send it to me on our message board at www.arirangradio.com/musicaccess or through your smartphone application. Alrighty. We'll come back right after a song for the All About Music quiz. So next we've got a song requested by Ray Sean from the USA, Alicia Keys with Brand New Me. All About Music and All About Quizzes. A great collaboration of music and quizzes. All About Music Quiz. A quiz that progresses receives praise, but a quiz that's always the same gets ignored. All About Music Quiz is, to say the least, the most progressive quiz you'll ever come across. Well, 5 different music quizzes from Monday through Friday. Get ready for the great music and have fun answering the quizzes. We even have a very special prize for just one lucky listener who sends in the correct answer. So for today, our AA music quiz prize is Kylie Minogue's album, Kiss Me Once, provided to us by Warner Music. So for our first AA music quiz, the format for today is guessing the musical instrument. So I'm going to let you guys hear a short part of a song. And if you listen carefully, you'll hear the song and lyrics, but you'll also hear a musical instrument being played. So you got to ignore everything else and just focus on that. You just need to tell me what that musical instrument is. All right. So let's listen to the song now. Listen carefully. There it is. No, not this one. This one. I don't know if you're watching right now, but it's really nice. I feel so peaceful. Did you hear the instrument? All you gotta do is just tell me what it is. And for those of you who might be confused for some reason out there, here is a bonus hint, okay? It's an instrument that is stringed and it's percussive as well. Did you get that? That might be a little difficult, I guess. Well, Most people sit down while they're playing this. Okay, that's all I got for you. Did you guys get that? Because don't worry, if you didn't hear or you thought it was a little hard, we still have the second official hint coming up. And if you do know the answer, all you gotta do is just write answer on the title and send me your message. We're gonna listen to a song and come back with the second hint for AA Music Quiz. Up next, we've got Royal Pirates, My Band, with Betting Everything, requested by Kim Jia from Korea. The song you just heard was Betting Everything by Royal Pirates, and just so you guys know, I crack up every time the dubstep part comes out. It's so funny to me. Anyway, a collaboration between music and quizzes, all about music quiz. So, for our first AA music quiz, the format for today is guessing the musical instrument, and it's time for our second hint. So the second hint is similar to the first one. You'll be able to hear a part of a song, and you need to guess the musical instrument that's being played. I think this one might be a little bigger hint than the first one. So are you ready? You gotta listen carefully. There it is. That's all you need. Did you hear the instrument at the beginning of this song? All you gotta do is tell me what that instrument is. And remember the bonus hint that I gave you earlier? Here it is again one more time. It's a percussive instrument as well as being a stringed instrument. So, that's it for all the hints. If you know what the answer is, just write answer on the title when you send in your messages on our message board. And if you think you know the answer, come to the Music Access message board at www.arirangradio.com/musicaccess and leave us your answer with the title answer. Our AA Music Quiz prize is Kylie Minogue's album, Kiss Me Once, provided to us by Warner Music. Okay, before we move on, let's listen to one more song. Up next was requested from Hannah from Korea, Nuis, 여보세요.
Think about you, girl. What would I be without you, girl? Don't tell me lies, don't say goodbye. I just wanna let you know. I only think about you, girl. What would I be without you, girl? What would I be without you, girl?
The song you just heard was 여보세요 by New East. It's time to listen to some more of your stories with Message Time. Alrighty, Janella Kate from the Philippines says, "How are you? I'm a big fan of Royal Pirates. I'm getting jealous of others because you've been noticing them and I got ignored." And then hoo hoo hoo, I don't know if that means ha ha ha, but or if it's sad, I don't know. But I even sent you a direct message on your SNS, so please check it out. Anyway, I wish I can see you guys perform here in the Philippines. I'm dying to see you guys. Good luck to the three of you. Please play Soul Hillbilly or Haru. I love you, James. And there's literally that many letters in each of the words that I extended. And we'll get to those songs if we can when we do have time, okay? But as far as noticing other people and ignoring you, I'm not purposely ignoring you. I'm sorry about that. But I don't check my direct messages because my spam box, my direct message box is kind of packed right now. So there's too many, and I'm sorry that I couldn't get to you, but I'm glad that I could say hello right now. So hello, Janella Kate. I hope this does it for ya. Okay. Amy from England says, "Hi, Spider James. Amy from England here again. Thank you so much for reading my message last time. Hope your weekend was great and that you're wrapping up warm for the cold weather. Don't catch a cold. And I was wondering, Could you please sing your part in You, the English version, because I'm addicted to your voice. I'm really going to miss waking up to your voice after tomorrow. I love you, James. Keep smiling and being the inspiration you are. And I really hope to meet you, Moon Soo-yoon, when I visit Seoul for the first time in the summer. Is it cool if I sing that part, PD님? If it's cool with you, I'll sing it. It goes, oh, baby, I don't know what I'd be without you. I'm going crazy. Oh, I like how the reverb came in halfway. Yeah. Yeah, I think I forgot the second part. It goes something like that. I hope that did it for you. I'm going to practice singing now because I've just been practicing bass for a while. But okay, thank you for the message, Amy. Lynn from Singapore says, hello, James. My brother Leon is starting his first day of work tomorrow. Leon and I are both fans of the Royal Pirates, hoping to see you guys perform in Singapore soon. It's snowing today in Korea, so stay warm, but don't catch a cold. With love, Lynn from Singapore. Lynn, thank you so much. Good luck to your brother Leon on his first day of work. I know that's pretty exciting. It was my first day on the radio last week, so I know how nerve-wracking it can be. Just tell him it's okay to make mistakes. And thank you for sending in this message. I don't know, is it cold in Singapore now? If it is, stay warm, but I don't think it is. So just stay warm either way. Joanna from the USA says, hello, DJ James and the Music Access family. Happy 1st of December. Keep warm, DJ James and MA friends. I want to wish you all a wonderful day and night. Take care. Much love from Joanna from the States. So she wants to wish everybody, not just me, but all the MA friends, wonderful day and night. Georgia Sanchez from the Philippines says, happy December 1st. Again, I don't have class for today. My next class is on Thursday, yeah, and I have time to study my lessons while listening to Music Access. It's good to see and hear you, DJ James. It's good to see. Well, I guess I can't see you, but I can hear from you guys. Red t-shirt fits you. Thanks. Well, anyway, have a great Monday, everyone. Fighting. I'm going to get to a couple more messages. I want to squeeze everyone in because I only got 2 more days here on Music Access. Daphne from the USA says, hello, MA friend. I like your red shirt again. Okay. I guess I should wear red more often. Looking on the screen, it's kind of like my red shirt. My head is floating because my red shirt fits in with the background right here. I guess I shouldn't wear red too often. Well, you guys might get confused. But anyway, your DJ is getting much better. It's sad that tomorrow is your last day. Sad face. Does that mean I was terrible when I began? Because now I feel pretty comfortable. So I guess back then. Well, thank you for the message of improvement. And Asia from Bulgaria says, this is the last message I'm going to get to before the next song. But hello, James. Happy 1st of December. Wow, it's already December. How are you, James? How's your weekend? Or how was your weekend? And that sounds so nice of sweet and sweet of you that you already know some of the people's names. By the way, thank you for reading my questions in the weekend and answering them. Have a fantastic day and take care with love. Well, usually when people send in messages consistently, it's easier to remember who they are. So just keep sending your messages. And thank you so much. My weekend was packed with eating too much food and practicing too much. My hands are sore. Anyway, thanks to everyone who sent in your messages for message time. Let's hurry up and listen to a song before we come back with more. Requested by Alex from the USA. Up next, we've got Zion T with Yanghwa Daegyo. Alright, the song you just heard was Yanghwa Daegyo by Zion T. And it's already time to wrap up the first hour, but don't worry. In the second hour, we're going to be back with the lovely, the delightful Tasha for a Monday Corner My Treasure Box. So, don't go away. We'll be right back after this song requested by Xiao from Malaysia, Chromio's Old 45s.
Korea, a journey to find the hidden gems of Korean local food.
Music Access. I'm James from Royal Pirates, filling in here for Aaron here on Music Access. And in the second hour today, we'll be having Tasha join us in the studio in just a bit. Our Monday Corner, My Treasure Box, is all about the special things that make us think back on the precious moments in our lives. Just write My Treasure Box on your title and share with us what kind of special, memorable moments you have. You can also listen to us by visiting our website, www.arirangradio.com/musicaccess, and leave your messages there on our message board. You can also see our broadcast in real time. And another way you can tune in is through the terrestrial DMB, but this is only available for our listeners living on Jeju Island. The frequencies are 88.7 for Jeju City, 88.1 for Seokgwipo, and 101.9 for Daejeong. Alrighty, after listening to a song, we'll come back with the ever so lovely Tasha for My Treasure Box, requested by Sarah from the USA. This is Taemin with Kwedo. Things that aren't special to others, but hold great meaning to me.
A special time to share about our special items.
My treasure box. Hello, 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 Tasha.
Oh, hi, Dave.
You want to say hi to the listeners because you're facing
this
way.
Hey, guys.
Right. Hello, Tasha. So, I've met with all the other guests on Music Access, but
okay. It's
the first time meeting you, right?
Yes. But I think we met quite a few times on programs. And
yeah, you know what? I actually... Mm-hmm. So, Tasha, she has a really familiar face.
Mm-hmm.
But I got the feeling when I first met... If you guys know Tasty...
Yes.
There's one of my really good buddies. His name is Taeryong. Mm-hmm. Or that means big dragon.
Right?
Big dragon introduced mm-hmm. me to her when we were doing the Idol Olympics.
Yes.
We were doing the Olympics for the idols, which I terribly failed.
He was like, hey, this is James and this is Tasha.
Yeah. But it was so, like, time was...
Right.
It was so chaotic that we weren't able to properly say hi to each other.
Right,
but
right.
It's nice to actually meet you where I can I can hear your name completely, Tasha.
Wow, nice to meet you, too.
Nice to meet you.
Mm-hmm.
And it hasn't been that long, but I got the feeling that there are many female guests on this show. And... They're all beautiful, but why do you think that you're so beautiful?
What question is that?
I'm reading the script.
Well, guys.
She's so confused right now. Oh, okay. Well, maybe the listeners can write in if they have anything to say about that. Apparently, well, it's December 1st today.
Right.
What's the first thing that comes to your mind knowing that today is the first day of December? Is there anything that you wanted to accomplish before this year's over?
Well, I don't think, like, accomplish, but I just want to spend more time with my family.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I know how that feels. Are they in Singapore?
Yes, they are.
Is anybody out here, like, from your family out here?
No.
No? So you're alone right now. So, I know, I know how that feels. I cope with that by eating. You should eat a lot.
No, but we gain weight.
Who cares? Just let's be free. Everyone just eat. Eat up. What is the deal?
Exercise, you mean?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Because the reason I work out is to eat. I don't eat.
Yeah.
I don't eat.
Yeah, I get what you mean.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It's life isn't fun without tasty food. Well, anyway, our Monday corner, My Treasure Box, it's a corner for our listeners to share about special items that hold great meaning for them, right?
Mm-hmm, right.
But you've been on this corner for a while, apparently,
mm-hmm.
right? So you probably talked about your precious treasures, your precious items before. But do you think you could tell me again, since it's my first time on this corner, what's something precious for you?
Actually, I don't remember what I actually said on the program.
Uh-huh. But is there anything recently that...
Recently?
Just got your attention and can't get off your mind? Nothing in particular?
Yeah.
No?
Recently, yeah.
Well, for me,
do you have,
I was going to say, when I graduated high school,
okay.
I my mom gave me this graduation necklace, but the Aww. Problem is,
okay.
so I'm in a rock band, right?
Mm-hmm.
But this is like a gangster chain. It's like, Aww. It goes all the way down here, and I have no, I don't know what I can wear it with. Unless,
wow, your mom gave it to you?
Yeah.
Wow. She,
it's so meaningful and
uh-huh.
it's so sweet,
mm-hmm.
but I'm not like a, hey, what up?
Right.
You know, I'm not a rapper.
You can just wear it inside, like,
yeah,
under
but
your
it's
shirt.
Cold and it's
oh,
freezing.
Oh, right.
You go out, did you come, I don't know, you guys
wow.
don't know, but in Korea right now, it's like a huge ice cream cone. It's
right.
freezing right
The
now.
Wind is so strong.
Yeah, it's chaotic.
yeah.
But,
today.
Mm. Yeah, so for me, it was this silver
necklace.
Chain that I had. And anyway, I'm going to ask you if
okay.
you've collected or kept these items in the past before, okay?
Okay.
So I have a few questions for you.
Mm-hmm.
And all I need you to do is answer yes or no. Is that,
okay.
is that easy? Okay.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Have you collected albums or pictures of celebrities when you were young? Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes? Who? Mm. Who are some of these people?
I think the very first celebrity was, Westlife.
Westlife?
Yes, I think the
what?
Very first, I collected with my brother. Really?
Your brother collected Westlife?
Right.
Wow.
And then he moved on, I think, to Backstreet Boys, and then...
Usually it's the other way around, no? It's
but like, for us, I think we listen more of Westlife
oh.
first, and then...
Is there
yeah.
a song that you recommend?
Well, I can't no, think
just
of
all
anything
of them?
No. Yeah.
All of them are pretty
just love
good.
Every song. We love to sing along to all of it.
So you were always into, like, this boy band, like, idol...
No, I think
no?
that was, like, when I was, like, really young.
Oh,
but
okay.
when I started to grow up, I started to like Chinese pop a lot.
Oh, okay.
Like,
all right.
singers in Taiwan... And
oh,
China stuff.
You got like Jay Chow, and
mm-hmm.
you like those.
Right,
oh,
when
okay.
I was in school.
Ah, all right, all
right. How about you?
For me, I did not collect Westlife, but I was a fan of Baby Box.
Oh, oh.
I know, but I didn't collect their.
But
like,
you like their songs, and
I like their songs. But as far as collectibles, I think Pokemon. I really like Pokemon.
Yeah.
Is that so childish?
Right. No, I do collect them too. Like I played the games.
Oh, okay.
Right.
Okay. Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. We're on the same page. Okay. So, have you ever kept a letter or a message from a person that you liked? Yes or no.
Yes.
Yes?
Mm.
That's kind of obvious, right?
Right. I think a message.
Yeah. Everyone always keeps...
Mm-hmm.
It feels like when they're feeling down, they look at it and they're
right.
like,
oh my God.
Can read yeah. it again and again and again.
And actually, our fans send us messages.
Oh, yes. Stuff. I do keep them too.
And when you're feeling like times are tough, it's
mm-hmm.
good to look back at those.
Right.
Okay. Have you ever kept a picture of yourself
mm-hmm.
when you were younger that looked especially good? Yes or no?
No.
No?
No.
You don't collect... pictures of your past?
I do, but I don't, because I was really quite not, as in, I looked quite ugly when I was young.
What?
So, yeah.
I cannot believe it. Well, they say that when people are ugly when they're children, they become beautiful when they're older.
All right,
so
is that...
I guess you're like the proven case of
well,
that,
Well, yeah, but I was quite, like, yeah, not very...
You just like flexing your arms. Were you really strong?
No, no, like
when you're
big,
younger?
You know, big and...
Ah.
Yeah, so...
Okay, so you worked
look
hard?
Good.
You worked hard?
I
and
think
you...
just, you know, naturally when I grow up, you know, just
okay.
starts to go.
Wow, well,
off.
Congratulations to
Thank
you.
Thank you.
And I'm sad that there's no pictures of that, but okay,
mm-hmm.
moving on. Have you ever kept an award or
mm-hmm.
report card from your school days that you're really proud of? Yes or no?
No.
You're never proud of yourself for your grades.
Right.
You're in a student.
No.
Oh, okay.
No, yeah, actually. Yeah. Well, my school days, no, but I've been to like a lot of competitions with my
mm-hmm.
brother,
mm-hmm.
like dance competitions.
Okay.
So we collect a lot of awards.
No, okay, that's
mm-hmm.
awesome then. So you apparently everyone Tasha is the best dancer
no,
in this room because I am a terrible
you
dancer.
You don't dance?
I danced a few times and on the message board, everyone was really angry. They were like, James, please stop. You're hurting our eyeballs.
Yeah.
I got to ask Taeryong for help.
Mm-hmm.
And he's always like, hey, yo, I'm in China.
Right,
he talks
right,
like that. Right.
He has that
like
accent.
That? But yeah, that's what he was saying. He's in China right now.
Mm-hmm.
But when he comes back, you,
oh.
me, Taeryong, dance off.
It was so fun.
Okay?
Okay.
All right, sounds good. Also, have you ever kept a picture of your family where you all look really happy together? Yes or no?
I think my mom kept it, but I don't have actually
you
one.
Don't have it? Mm. Yeah, well, the good thing is we're in the age of information. They could just send it over through the internet.
Right.
So it's all good, but I personally collect pictures of my family on my phone, which is kind of weird, you know, because it's nothing but family, and then out of nowhere, it's me making like
so
a stupid face. Or like, I'm like a Korean girl, I take a picture of my food. Well, anyway, okay. Well, I think it's time for a song break before we come back with more information, okay? So up next, we've got Soyu and Kwon Sunil and Park Yongin with Tum. The song you just heard was Tum by Soyu and Kwon Sunil and Park Yongin. I'm James from Royal Pirates, filling in for Aaron here on Music Access, and you're listening to our Monday Corner, My Treasure Box, with the lovely Tasha. So let's find out what's in your treasure box. Here are some more messages sent to us by our listeners. Tasha, can you open it up? Can you read the first one?
Okay. We have Aaron Johnson from the USA. Mm-hmm. I have a statue of Ariel and Eric from the movie The Little Mermaid.
Okay.
My dad sent it to me for Christmas 7 years ago after he and my sister had gone to Disney World. It means a lot to me because it reminds me of the first time my dad took me to Disney World when I was 15.
Ah. Mm. You know, when I was younger, I had a toy as well, a tiger.
Okay.
And
a
it
tiger.
Really meant a lot to me. I got it from this burger place as a happy
like happy meal kind
yeah,
of thing
something like that but as a prize, and my sister got really mad at me and she cut the tail off.
No,
she cut the tail off and it shocked me for anyway. I don't want to make this a crisis, but I'm gonna move on. But yeah,
do you still have it?
No, it was so traumatic.
Oh,
it had no tail. Anyway, okay, I'm gonna read a message from Hannah Peck from Korea. My younger sister has a sky blue bear that she had since her birth.
Mm.
So they do have the same age. She can't sleep without him.
Mm.
And when we were younger, we were getting ready to go to bed. Then suddenly she screamed. I asked what's wrong, and she said her bear is gone. What? And asked me to help her look for him.
That's so cute.
No, that's terrifying. We spent an hour wide awake just for the stupid bear. And in the end, we found him under the blanket the whole time. He wasn't missing at all. Did you have a teddy bear or something like that you treasured as a kid? I just told you about my tiger that got its tail cut off. Did you, Tasha, how about you? Did you ever have anything like that?
I don't have a teddy bear, but I had a bolster.
A bolster?
Like a really small cushion that I used when I was a baby.
So did it have like arms and legs?
No, it's just a... Yeah, I brought it to Korea too.
Ah, but it reminds you of back then. Oh, okay.
Right.
Alrighty. Can you read the next one, please?
Okay. We have Darcy Ann from the USA too. When I was in the 7th grade, I took a class in home economic sewing, which was when I found that I can sew and that I enjoyed it very much. My grandma sent me a new sewing machine she bought for me. I don't sew all the time, but when I do, I usually make gifts for friends. The last thing I made was a baby blanket for my good friend, Beth, who is going to have a baby in December. Someone made me an embroidered patch that says Made with Love by Darcy Ann 2014.
Mm-hmm.
I sent the blanket to her and she was surprised, but told me it was beautiful.
Okay.
Do you sew?
I don't sew.
No?
Yeah, I do like jujitsu.
What's jujitsu?
Jujitsu is like kind of like wrestling.
Oh.
But it's not like sewing.
No, it's not.
So, I don't sew, but... Yeah, but it sounds like something that some people might enjoy. Well, I'm glad that Darcy Ann has those things. Okay, so this next message is from Bella from Canada. I love Legos. When I was young, I thought I would make one last piece before I have to put away my Legos to study hard. So I made a model of my dream home that I want to live in when I grow up. I still have it today. It's a really nice two-story house. Wow. That's pretty. Maybe
a dream home.
I'm wondering if Bella was an architect or some kind of, you know, home builder, mm-hmm. or maybe you'll get into real estate or something like that. That's amazing.
Legos.
But if I had Legos, I think if I was building my dream house, mm-hmm. it would have 10 stories.
I knew you were going to say that. Like 10 stories.
10 stories mm-hmm. with a swimming pool full of Jell-O on the second floor. And the third floor would have a soda fountain.
Wow.
That's really childish, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
I've got a little kid inside of me. Alrighty.
Next, we have Megumi from Japan. Mm-hmm. The day I graduated, the boy that I liked gave me a bouquet of roses.
Wow.
I dried the roses and kept it next to my bed. I think I should throw it away now, but I can't bring myself to do it.
Man,
wow.
You probably had the same problem, right, Tasha?
No.
When you were younger, you had too many flowers.
And no, I've never received any flowers before.
Don't lie.
Really?
You're such a liar.
No,
because
I'm not.
I know that in your home, you had flowers all over rotting. Because, no, it's not true?
No, I've all never right. received flowers before.
That's crazy.
Oh, is it?
Yeah. When I was younger... When I was in second grade is when I first gave a flower to a girl.
Oh.
And I was shaking. I was literally
so
shaking.
Cute.
I gave her the flower that I took from my neighbor's yard.
Oh, you didn't buy it?
I didn't have money. I'm in second grade. But I pricked myself on the thorn.
Oh.
And then I put it in a paper cup and I gave it to her and she said thank you.
Did she like it?
She loved it. And I thought, from that day, I thought I was really, really romantic. But I just realized I was really, really weird. I was a really weird second grader.
In second grade.
Yeah. But we also get flowers sometimes from the fans as well.
Oh, right, right.
Sometimes we get the preserved ones.
Right.
So they don't rot mm-hmm. or anything like that. Mm-hmm. So that's kind of cool.
It just stays forever.
Yeah, mm-hmm. it's kind of awkward when you have a flower from right. somebody and it's dying.
Right, right.
And you don't know how to... Yeah. I don't know what I would do with that either. Mm-hmm. But anyway...
Thank you. Thanks
so much for everyone for sending in your messages. All right, let's take another break before we come back with more. Up next, we've got GOT7 with Haji Hajima. Alrighty, the song you just heard was Haji Hajima by GOT7. Okay. Let's find out what's in your treasure box. Here are some more messages sent to us by our listeners. So, Tasha, can you read the first one?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
We have Mara from the USA. Mm-hmm. I have one special item in my treasure box. Mm-hmm. A teddy bear that's older than you, James. It's 30 years old, and it was given to me by my older sister when I was only 3 years old.
Wow. that's been a while.
Right.
But awesome. Okay.
Old Bobo. I think the name of the teddy bear is Old Bobo. Mm-hmm. Old Bobo and I have been through it all. Mm-hmm. He stayed with me during stormy Texas nights of my childhood, windy, snowy, wintry weather of Chicago during my 20s, and of course the chilly, rainy days of Seattle now that I'm in my 30s. Mm. I recently checked out his tech, and do you know what? It looks like Bobo was made in Korea.
Yeah!
Wow. And of all the places, I guess, my love for Korea started long before I realized it.
Man, I want to see old Bobo.
Wow.
Bobo's my 형님.
Hyungnim.
Bobo is 30 years old. Yeah, wow. Okay, or older than 30 years old.
I'm curious.
I don't think I have any object that's over 30 years old, but...
That's older than you?
Maybe... No, I don't have any object like that. But I know that guitars, as time goes on, mm-hmm. you know, because it's made out of wood,
uh-huh.
it actually sounds better.
Oh.
As wood ages, it sounds more full.
Wow.
The sound will be... Yeah, it's really, really interesting.
Wow. Mm.
That's why guitars' value typically goes up mm-hmm. if the quality mm-hmm. of the guitar is good. But more than that, old Bobo or this teddy bear.
Old Bobo. That's so cute.
It's valuable. It's invaluable, mm-hmm. I'm guessing, because 30 years of... Like, for me, I just had that little tiger doll for literally about 2 years.
And
it was my world. It was really my... Do you know Calvin and Hobbes, by any chance? It's a cartoon about a mm-hmm. little boy with a pet tiger.
Okay.
But it's just his imagination going mm-hmm. out and about. But I used to love this series, this mm-hmm. book series. And I used to imagine myself as that character.
Uh-huh.
So when my sister cut off this tail...
Oh, why did she cut that off?
She was so mad. I think she was on the phone, and I kept on picking up the phone while she was on the phone.
So you started this.
I started it, but she didn't have to finish it like that. You can be responsible. Well, yeah. But, no, that'd be... Somehow, can we somehow send the picture of old Bobo to us?
That'd be nice. Yeah, I'm quite curious.
All right. We've got a message from Kim Ji-young from Korea. So, I went to a concert of a singer that I really liked back then for the first time when I was in middle school. During the concert, the singer got really into his song, and he started slamming his guitar on the ground and broke it.
Wow.
I thought it was really awesome. And as I was coming out after the concert, I saw a piece of the guitar on the ground, and I still have it with me today. Whenever I see the piece, I still remember the emotions from that day. It was really thrilling.
Wow.
Have you ever had an experience like that?
No.
No, you've never...
I've been to concerts, but...
Did you ever stand in the front of the concert and, like, cheer and dance with the... No?
Yeah.
Like, what kind of concerts did you go to?
Oh, yes, I have. I think Lady Gaga concert, the recent one.
That must have been crazy in Korea.
Yeah.
How was it?
It was great, but I was standing, like, actually quite...
Quite far.
Mm-mm.
But was the energy...
It was great.
Must have been insane. Lady Gaga, I heard her concerts, she's got the most wild things going on stage. Did she have, like, a crazy meat outfit like she did that one time?
Like, I think all the outfits are quite, unusual. Right.
Well... For me, I've been to a lot of concerts in the States, and these are maybe 300-400 seaters, so not they're really packed. Mm-hmm. They're in these small areas, but to me those are the best. Mm-hmm. And there's this band called Say Anything. Say Anything is a pop rock band, and the guitarist at the end of the tour threw his guitar into the crowd.
Okay,
well, he didn't break it or anything. He threw it into the crowd. Mm-hmm. But I grabbed the guitar because I wanted to take it home.
Mm-hmm.
And everyone around me grabbed a piece of the guitar.
So it broke?
No, it didn't break, but the security had to escort us all out. And in the end, they gave the guitar to a little girl. A different little girl. So I was fighting this little girl for this guitar. But in the process of holding the guitar, the strings ripped off.
Okay.
And they slapped my arms. And I was injured on my arm because of that. But what I'm saying is, it was one of the best concerts of my life. Not because of that, but that was part of the experience.
Wow.
And soon, we're going to be playing some shows as well.
Mm-hmm.
And you should come, and all your friends should come. And everyone listening to Arirang should come on December 16th. I said this before.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't know if I'm going to be slamming my guitar on the ground, you know, because those things can get kind of pricey.
Right.
You know? But if I feel it, we'll see where that goes. But those guitars can get from like $2,000 to $10,000. Each guitar.
$10,000? Wow.
Yeah,
I'm
so
shocked.
That guy must have been really into it.
Mm-hmm.
Alrighty. Well, we've got some more messages. Can you read that, please?
We have Rayshawn Moore. How do you...
Rayshawn Moore.
Moore from USA.
Mm-hmm.
I had a snow globe collection when I was younger, and every time we went to a new place, I would always try to get a snow globe.
Mm.
Once, my family and I went to the Lion King musical, and we visited the store afterwards.
Mm-hmm.
I spotted a snow globe, and my mom bought it for me, despite being a bit pricey. I always favored that one snow globe until it sadly broke when we were in the process of moving.
No.
It's okay, since it's still a good memory with my family.
Yes. You know... Did you ever collect snow globes?
I don't collect that. Is it the one?
Yeah, you shake them and there's like glitter.
Right.
So I was on Twitter the other day and I saw how to make a on-the-budget snow globe.
Wow.
And you it's you just literally can make it for like $5, but it's not very good.
Okay.
But you put glitter inside and it falls down, you know, onto the city. But that's a nice object to keep.
Snow globe, right.
To keep collecting. But I think it might be a little difficult if you have a lot. Because they're kind of heavy, right?
Yeah.
And if you're going to have
them... And it's fragile. Like, it can break any time.
Yeah, it's fragile. But it seems like most of these messages are coming from people who have had these memories with their family.
Right.
So when they're younger.
Mm-hmm.
And even for me, the chain was when I got it as a graduation gift from my mom. And it wasn't so much because I graduated, but more so because my mom took the effort to do that for me.
Did she make it?
She didn't make it, but it was difficult times at that time.
Right.
Things, we didn't grow up very, very super affluent, super rich or anything, but she made it a point to tell me that she was proud of me, you know, and that she cared. And I think most of these objects, they're people investing their heart into their families, and so that's a big part of why people are so attached to these items. All right, we've got one more item in the treasure box from Nur Rashida Husaimi from Singapore.
Yay.
Okay, your hometown. My special moment is when I danced to Gangnam Style with Psy on stage in Singapore. I never liked performing in front of large crowds, but hey, now I love it because I find it fun and I'm able to entertain the audience. I was never lucky, but during that time, I felt like I was the luckiest girl alive. Although I know I'm not, but that's wrong. You know what? You are... That's.
I think you're lucky.
That's really, really lucky. Psy is one of the world's greatest performers. And the dance for my sister's wedding. She had a wedding recently.
Okay.
I have an older sister, a younger sister. My older sister just got married. But it was very diverse. Okay. The wedding was very... There was... When I say diverse, I mean there's very... A huge set of ethnicities.
Okay.
But when Gangnam Style came out, when they were introducing my parents.
Okay.
All right, so my mom and dad were dancing the Gangnam Style at the wedding. And literally to about a verse. And it was the loudest roar. Like everybody was like, yeah! Yeah. Gangnam Style. And
everyone knows it.
And everyone was into it. And it was the most heartfelt, most sweetest time for me. But yeah, like, Psy...
Dancing with Psy, wow.
Not just to Psy, because to be able to watch Psy is a huge experience, but to be able to perform with Psy...
With him.
That's something that I'm pretty sure... Wouldn't you want to do that
Yeah,
as
I
well?
Would love to do that.
Because if you guys don't know, Tasha is a world-class dancer.
No.
She is the best dancer in this room.
Okay, in this room.
Yeah, I don't know about the studio, because the engineer looks like he can dance. But we'll see afterwards. We'll try to bring him in here, but I don't know if he'll agree with it. But Tasha's a world-class dancer, and she wants to dance with
Psy, of course.
And I think I would as well, if he would allow me to. You are the luckiest girl. Nur Rashida Husaimi, thank you for messaging in. Well, thanks so much to everyone for sending in your message. My treasure box, it's a corner for us to share about our precious items. And Tasha... She will be in here next week with Erin for more. So please be sure to tune in again and send in your messages about the special items that you want to share with us. Well, it's almost time for us to wrap things up already. How do you feel about that? I had fun today. What about you?
It was really, really nice meeting you.
You had a good time? How was it compared to being with Erin in the studio?
Well...
Are you able to communicate with Erin better because he's a dancer? And
no, I think that doesn't matter.
You had a good time,
I think we're more comfortable, like, because we're the same age, and I've been with him, like, since... Yeah.
Yeah, if you guys can't tell by the back of Tasha's head, she's very uncomfortable still.
No,
I'm just playing around. But thank you so much for coming in.
Thank you.
I hope we'll be able to meet again soon.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Hopefully we won't have to wait till next year. But thank you for coming in, Tasha. Sending out Tasha. Here's with a song, all right? So you can say bye to everybody. This is Taylor Swift with Shake It Off. Bye.
Bye.
Anyway, I wanted to know, have you ever been to Atlanta? And if not, please come soon. I know it's far away from your home, but really fun. Good luck on all your future endeavors. Well, thank you so much, Cora. Our music style, the fact that you like our music style, that means the most to me right now, as far as this message, because we put so much effort into that. And I just want you to know, in the future, we're just focusing on developing our own rhythm and our own style. So thank you for that. And I have never been to Atlanta, but my sister has, and she told me that it's amazing. So I got to go because the food sounds delicious. Alrighty. Mates from Peru says, hello, DJ James. My name is Mate, and I really enjoy listening to your sexy voice on the radio. And tomorrow I will be taking an important exam, so I am really nervous. I hope that you can wish me good luck for tomorrow and give me some advice to control my nerves. Thanks for reading my message and have a good day. Well, I'm glad that I could do that for you, and I didn't know that my voice was sexy until right now, but I will, from the future, I will know that within every time I use it. And as far as being really nervous, I was extremely nervous about 10 seconds ago when I lost the papers, so just like me, I think you should be okay with making some mistakes. It's alright to make mistakes every once in a while, and that's what I did when I took important exams, too. I always gave myself a cushion, okay? So I think you should do that. Next up, Ruzi from Indonesia says, "Hello, James, a.k.a. Santiago the Teddy Bear. Happy face. Happy first day of December. How is your weekend? I have an amazing weekend. I met with my friends who came from another city, and we spent time together and ate lots of delicious food. Oh, right, we ordered yummy Korean foods and ate green tea bingsu. Oh gosh, writing this while my tummy is growling. I need to take my lunch since it's 12 p.m. here at my place. Have you eaten yet, James? Oh, so nice to hear when we're called friends. It makes us feel closer to you. Have a great Monday, Santiago. Lots of love from Ruzi from Indonesia." Well, guess what? Thank you so much for that message, but I did not eat. Oh, I ate like crazy, but it feels like I didn't eat. I'm starving right now. It's only been like an hour and a half, and I'm so, man, I think this is what you get for being, I'm like 85 kilos right now. I don't know if I was supposed to say that, but yeah, I feel like getting some food to eat. Next up, Catherine from Canada says, "Hi James, it's me, Catherine, or Panda. Thank you so much for reading my Who Am I message. I thought my message would never be seen, and I'm not lucky for these things. Now I can say that Opa noticed me, can I? Actually, it's 1 a.m. here and I can't sleep. I have insomnia, new, NYU. Are you talking about the college? But I don't know if you're just making a noise, but do you have any advice, suggestions for me? Oh, and earlier you said bonjour, and I want to tell you, you said it perfectly. Love you, James. Have a nice day. Bonne journée." I don't know if that's how you say that last part, but for insomnia, for me, it's kind of rough too. I have insomnia sometimes. Soft music, but even sometimes that can get to you. Just close your eyes or shower again and then just lay in bed. And that's what I do. Alrighty, well, thanks to everyone who sent in your messages during message time. So let's listen to two more songs that were requested by our listeners. Oh, we're just going to go with one song. And this was requested from Satomi from Japan with CN Blue with Hey You.